अस्सलामुअलैकुम। सलामुअलैहिम। माय नेम इज़ आफ्ताब अलीम फारूकी। आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन बायोकेमिस्ट्री एट गवर्नमेंट डिग्री साइंस कॉलेज मलिर कराची। सो स्टूडेंट, आई एम स्टार्टिंग द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ सीरीज ऑफ ऑनलाइन लेक्चर, दैट इज़ लेक्चर नंबर 14। एंड टुडे आई एम स्टार्टिंग द लेक्चर फॉर बायोकेमिस्ट्री फॉर क्लास बीएससी पार्ट 2। And for this topic is here, continuation of this previous topic is metabolism of membrane lipids. So today I am starting the biosynthesis of glycerol ether phospholipids. This is another kind of membrane lipids, and the reference books which you will consider for the study of this topic is the same, Harper's Physiological Chemistry 23rd edition, and also Principles of Biochemistry by Albert Leninger. So students, I am starting biosynthesis of glycerol ether phospholipids. See, the biosynthetic pathway to ether lipids, that is plasmalogens, are formed by desaturation of the analogous 3-phosphoethanolamine derivative. It means that in this synthesis of this compound, the phosphoethanolamine derivative compound will be participated in the biosynthesis of plasmalogens, and this is the last step of the reaction which I will give you description later on. In the last stage process, the desaturation of the fatty acyl group will be takes place, fatty acyl chain will be desaturated. It means that saturation of the CH2CH2 molecule will be converted to CH-CH double bond. So next one is here, another topic is also included in this topic is platelet activating factor. So much of the phospholipids in mitochondria consist of plasmalogens, platelet activating factor synthesized from the corresponding 3-phosphocholine derivative. So here the important point is in the biosynthesis of these two components is that earlier in the biosynthesis of plasmalogens, 3-phosphoethanolamine will be participated, while in the later on platelet activating factor in the synthesis of this compound, 3-phosphocholine derivative will be participated, and it is formed by many blood cells and other tissues and aggregates platelets at a concentration low as 10^-11 moles per liter. Now students, the first precursor molecule or compound which is necessary for the biosynthesis of plasmalogen or platelet activating factor, that is dihydroxyacetone phosphate. This compound is required for the biosynthesis of these two compounds. So dihydroxyacetone phosphate, how it is formed? Because the dihydroxyacetone 3 carbon atom containing sugar will react with the ATP. Therefore, the third carbon atom, the hydrogen is here, CH2OH, that will be esterified, and then the phosphate group will be bonded from this oxygen in the form of covalent bond. Therefore, the dihydroxyacetone phosphate will be synthesized. So this dihydroxyacetone phosphate is a precursor of the glycerol moiety, of glycerol ether phospholipid. So this compound will react with the acyl coenzyme A in the presence of enzyme acyl coenzyme A transferase. Therefore, the acylation will be carried out at this first carbon atom of this alkali group, hydroxyl group. Here the hydrogen will be esterified for the incoming fatty acyl chain. Therefore, the hydrogen will be esterified through the esterification process, and acylation will be occur at the first carbon atom RCOO. This RCOOH is the fatty acid. This fatty acid will be acylated at the first carbon atom. Therefore, the nature of this compound will be changed in the next one step reaction, which is called the 1-acyl dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Okay, now in the second step of the reaction, this is the exchange reaction. The second step of the reaction is called the exchange reaction. The important point of this reaction is that there is an alkali group alcoholic group will be participated, will be added in this reaction in the presence of enzyme synthase, and this alcoholic group, alcoholic chain compound will be added at this first carbon atom again, that will remove the acyl group of the fatty acyl chain, and again it will be bonded with the first carbon atom of this position is here. Therefore, in the presence of enzyme, synthase enzyme will again will be participated, will be catalyzed this reaction of this alcohol chain compound at the first carbon atom. Therefore, RCOOH here, this will be removed, this RCOOH will be removed in this form. Therefore, the new one chain of the compound is called one alkyl position, because the alkyl group is here, one dihydroxyacetone phosphate. This compound will be formed. So in the next step of the reaction, this reaction is carried out in electron transport chain in the presence of NADPH2. This is reducing electron donor species. This reducing electron donor species will oxidize, and two hydrogen atom will be losses, and that will, this is the oxidized form, this is the reduced form of the NADPH2. That will be oxidized and they give off the two electrons, two hydrogen atom. That will be two hydrogen atom will reduce this oxygen negative charge at the second carbon atom of this carbonyl group. Therefore, the oxygen negative charge will again the hydrogen atom one of this and form the alcoholic group or hydroxyl group at the second carbon atom, and right side the hydrogen will be formed, hydrogen atom will be attached. Therefore, the nature of the next one compound will be called one alkyl, because the alkyl chain is here, and one alkyl dihydroxyacetone phosphate. So this next one compound will be formed. The reaction is here. I am telling you, this is called the one alkyl glycerol 3-phosphate. In the next step of the reaction, this I am again repeating here. In the previous one reaction, the NADPH2 reducing electron donor species will participate in this reaction, and two hydrogen atom will be losses, and that will be reduced to the second carbon atom of the previous one molecule, carbonyl group, and then carbonyl group oxygen one is will be gained the hydrogen atom, and then form the hydroxyl group at second carbon atom, and the right side the hydrogen will be formed. Therefore, the next one name of IUPAC name of the compound will be one alkyl, because one position is alkyl group is here, and glycerol, because this is the structure of glycerol, and 3-phosphate. One alkyl glycerol, the structure of the glycerol, and 3-phosphate is here. Now in the second step of the reaction, acylation will again occur in the presence of addition of acyl group. This acyl group will again participated in the presence of enzyme acyl transferase. Acyl transferase enzyme will transfer the acyl group RCOO at this second carbon atom position is here. This is the second carbon atom. So in the next step of the reaction, look here very keenly, that again the carbonyl the RCOO H, which will be fatty acid, will be in which the hydrogen will be esterified. This hydrogen atom will be esterified for the addition of the fatty acyl chain. Therefore, the new one synthesis of the compound will be called 1-alkyl 2-acyl, because two position is acylation, acyl group is attached, and 2-acyl glycerol 3-phosphate. So this is the next one compound will be formed here. So next in step of the reaction, the hydrogenation reaction is carried out, because water molecule will be added. So hydration will be occurred, water molecule will be added, this hydroxyl will be hydroxylation will be occur at the third carbon atom, because the phosphate group will be removed because of the addition of the water molecule in the presence of alcohol. Hydroxylation of the will be denoted by the water. This hydroxyl group will be denoted by the water, and it will remove the phosphate group in the presence of enzyme phosphohydrolase. Therefore, the next nature of the compound will be called 1-alkyl 2-acyl glycerol. Okay. Now students, here I am before explaining the next one intermediate biosynthesis of the compound, unstable intermediate biosynthesis compound, I would like to give you some brief detail of the previous one phospholipid compound, that is the phosphatidylcholine and phosphatidylethylamine. So in the previous one compound, what will happen, the phosphatidate compound was participated. So phosphatidate compound at the third carbon atom, the here you learn your memory that phosphate is attached at the sulcarbonatum position. So the cytidine triphosphate was participated in that reaction, and cytidine triphosphate will be broken down and then give off the two phosphate group at the 5' position of the for pentose sugar. Okay, so therefore the two phosphate will be removed in the form of orthopyrophosphate, and the the next one remaining compound was called cytidine monophosphate. That cytidine monophosphate will be attached at the disposition of the phosphatidate. That one position is here, one phosphate was already there and another cytidine monophosphate was also formed. The two phosphate group were also attached in the previous lecture. So the cytidine monophosphate was formed. Here is not necessary for the addition of that reaction. You should know very well. So the cytidine monophosphate in next step of the reaction, cytidine diphosphocholine will participate. So cytidine diphosphocholine, acyl glycerol phosphocholine transferase. What will happen? This cytidine monophosphate will be removed and cytidine diphosphocholine compound will be here. Here is the structure of does not remain necessary to mention. So this just a choline which is phosphorylated at this position. This hydro, so the cytidine monophosphate will be removed, and again the for this hydrogen will be bonded the covalent bond from this choline phosphate group. So next one compound will be called the 1 alkyl 2 acyl glycerol 3 phosphocholine. 1 alkyl 2 acyl glycerol 3 phosphocholine compound will be formed. So student, the next step of the reaction, this R3COO fatty acyl group will be removed because of the addition of the water molecule in the presence enzyme phospholipase. So here the just a little change will occur at the second carbonate position. Here the acylation will be removed. It means the fatty acyl chain will be removed and the water molecule will be added and form again the hydroxyl group. Okay, so R3COO H will be by sharing from this. Okay, this hydrogen that will be removed and form then form the combined with the RC double energy charge. RC double energy charge will share the will gain the hydrogen and form the RCOOH. Okay, fatty acyl chain will be removed and then hydroxyl group will be added. So the next one compound is called 1 alkyl 2 lysoglycerol 3 phosphocholine. Now students, in the last step of the reaction for the biosynthesis of platelet activating factor, this at second carbonate position, here the hydroxyl group was added by the addition of the water molecule. In the next step of the reaction, the acetyl coenzyme A will be added. Acetyl coenzyme A will be added in the reaction, and that will donate the acetyl group CH3COOCH3COOCOA. तो यहाँ से क्या होता है कि एसिटाइल को एंजाइम है यहाँ पर वो शेयर करता है इसके साथ सेकंड कार्बन के साथ, यहाँ से हाइड्रोजन रिमूव होता है. देयरफॉर द CH3COOA एसिटाइल ग्रुप विल बी एडेड एंड द नेक्स्ट वन नेचर ऑफ द कंपाउंड विल बी कॉल्ड 1 अल्काइल 2 एसिटाइल ग्लिसरॉल 3 फॉस्फोकोलीन एंड द कंपाउंड नेम विल बी कॉल्ड द प्लेटलेट एक्टिवेटिंग फैक्टर. सो देयरफॉर द वन type of the ether phospholipid, that is the platelet activating factor, will be completed. Now students, the next one biosynthesis of compound, that is plasmalogen, will be synthesis will be started from the this same compound 1 alkyl 2 glycerol. Here the nature is changed. The cytidine diphosphate ethanolamine will be participated, and that will remove the cytidine monophosphate in the presence of enzyme cytidine diphosphate ethanolamine alkyl acyl glycerol phosphoethanolamine transferase. Just simple as here, the cytidine diphosphate ethanolamine will be transferred, and then the cytidine monophosphate will be removed from this third carbon atom. So look at the reaction is very carefully. That next one compound will be formed 1 alkyl 2 acyl glycerol 3 phosphoethanolamine. Here the same nature of the reaction that was occurred in the previous one is here. Well, the difference is here in the between these two synthesis of the compound, the platelet activating factor synthesis, the cytidine diphosphate choline was involved, and the in the biosynthesis of plasmalogen, the cytidine diphosphate ethanolamine will be participated. So in the next step of the reaction, what will happen? Look at the very carefully. Is here that NADPH will be involved, and the desaturation reaction is carried out. In the pyrrolizine enzyme desaturates, where the desaturation will occur? In the pyrrolizine compound at this first carbonate position. Look at this first carbonate position is here, CH2CH2. It means you can write down the CH2CH2 two times. So here the CH2CH2 root ethylene bond will losses the two hydrogen atom from one each ethylene bond. So what will happen from this position is here. Look at very carefully. From this position, the one hydrogen atom will be losses from CH2CH2. Therefore, the double bond will be formed in between these two ethylene group. Therefore, the two hydrogen atom will be losses that will be combined to the oxygen. Okay, then form the water molecule, and this process carried out in the electron transport chain, particularly cytochrome B5 component. Okay, so the nature of the compound will be called one alkyl, two acyl glycerol, three phosphoethanolamine. Therefore, the compound will be formed plasma logen. This is the glycerol ether phospholipid. Okay. So we have completed the biosynthesis of two types of glycerol ether phospholipid. One is earlier we have completed platelectating factor, and the second one is called the plasma logen. Okay, so our topic regarding this chapter, lipid biometabolism, is still continuing. Here it is not ended. Okay, in the next one lecture I will continue. Thanks.